Okay, welcome back to part C of the second section in chapter 4. In this section, as with the previous ones, we're going to keep working on the engine area for the midsection. And what I want to focus on in this section primarily is a lot of the tubing pieces that we have going throughout the engine. If I go over to layer 2 so we can focus, or actually layer 3, so we can just focus on our concept, you'll notice that we've got these exhaust tubes right here coming back. We've already got these pieces basically modeled, but we still need to do the tubing right through here. We've got these ones and these ones, tubing right up here between these large pieces. And so we've got quite a few different sections of tubing that we want to add that will really help kind of bring the detail together and also give us a better idea of where we stand on all the detail. Obviously, since we've got so many different sections that have already been added and that still need to be added, it's easy to get lost in what we're doing. So adding some of the more prominent details will go ahead and help us keep organized and know where we're at. So the first thing that I want to do is to work with this kind of exhaust tube right in here. So we first have the mesh already modeled that we've done. And on these, you can see we've got these two pieces. So let's go and hit Tab to go into edit mode. First, let's select this one and by just hovering over and hitting L. And I want to go ahead and move it over such that it's not intersecting with this piece. So we can just go and hit G and X to snap to the X axis. We'll move it over such that it's lined up nicely. That looks good. And then also such that it's evenly kind of poking through this mesh here, I'm also going to move it up along the Z axis just a little bit. Then I also want to add in, curve this back around or move it up such that it goes in right through here. So let's go ahead and just rotate the whole piece up about like this, such that this is now pointing directly right along this path. We can go ahead and deselect everything. Then I'll select this piece and we'll hit R to rotate it around, and then G to move it in just a little bit such that it's going back into this piece. And then I also want to go ahead and move this top section of the tubing up. So we'll just Alt-right-click and Alt-shift-right-click to select these loops here. We'll move the first up a little bit, and then we can hit B and middle-click and drag to deselect that first loop, move this up a bit more, and then we'll deselect the second loop, and then move this one up as well until that fits nicely. Now, right now, it's still pushing through a little bit, so let's move it up a little bit further, about like that. Then we can Alt-right-click to select this loop, move it up. Same thing on these. We should probably go ahead and let's rotate these such that they fit the angle that the tubing is moving along, such that you actually get the right dimension on it. So we'll rotate that somewhere right in there. We'll move that up some more. Actually, let's go ahead and move it up a bit more such that we're following this angle that you can see through here. So this means I need to go ahead and rotate this, or actually just bring it up about like that. We can maybe bring this one down a bit more. And we'll rotate that somewhere like so. Okay, that looks good. Let's go ahead and move this piece a little bit. What I want to do is just rotate it around the Z axis to fit this angle right through here, just so it lines up with the rest of the detail in the form. So we'll just hit R and then Z to lock to the Z axis, rotate it in, and then we can left click and hit G and X, snap to the X axis, and then just move it in until it just about intersects with everything just a little bit before, give it a little bit of space, and that looks pretty good. You notice that we've got this piece attached to it. We'll probably go ahead and leave that as is, or we might send it back behind, but we'll wait on that until we have a better idea. Let's go ahead and add in our subsurf modifier. So I'll just hit shift space to unmaximize my view, add in a subsurf modifier. We can go and hit T to bring up our tool panel to hit shading for smooth, hit T again to hide that. Let's increase our subdivisions to 2 and turn on optimal display. We'll save our file, of course, and then I'll maximize my view again. And the first thing that I want to do is to go ahead and add in some creases and edge loops to sharpen these areas up. So first I'll add in a edge loop right through here, and then another one on the other side. Again, that's just Control R, and then as soon as you left click to place the loop, it automatically puts you in edge slide mode. So I'll just do this on each one of these to get them fairly sharp. And then if I want them even sharper, I can go in, select the loop next to it, and then hit Shift E to crease it. And let's just do a crease of, say, 0.8 should be about right for what we want to do. Okay, if you hit Tab to leave edit mode, you can see how it looks. And I could go ahead and add in a crease along this loop, but since this is a bit of an exhaust piece, you'll generally tend to see, you know, this is perhaps molded metal or pressed metal, and so these corners will tend to be rounded. So I'm going to go ahead and leave that as is, but I do want to crease this one right down here. So again, I'll just hit Shift E, 0.8, and then that looks pretty good. Okay, and then let's go ahead and go down to this side. And I want to sharpen it up a little bit. And this I'm going to add in a flat edge right in here. And actually, we'll do that over here as well. So let's add in another loop right up to this edge. And then another loop right up to that edge. And then we can also crease both of these edges here one at a time by selecting it, Shift-E and 0.8. And we'll do that one over here, Shift-E and 0.8. Now you'll notice that we're getting a little bit of distortion right along this side. And it's because, you know, this is trying to smooth out over this whole distance, and we're basically stretching the polygons in here. So let's just add in another loop right up to each side there, which will strengthen that up a little. So now we've got a nice, clean edge. Okay, now to create the tubing, actually, the way that we're going to do this is rather than extruding vertices one by one, or excuse me, loops one by one, and just kind of trying to make it fit, we're going to do it a little bit differently, such that it's actually really easy. And we're going to do this using an actual curve. So with our cursor centered, if it's not centered, just hit Shift C. And then we can just hit Shift A, and we're going to add in a curve and Bezier curve. On this curve, then, we can go ahead and see that we've got a kind of a sloping line. So let's first go into edit mode. And if you're not familiar with curves, basically the way that it works is we have, by default, there's two points, 0.1 and 0.2. And on these, they also have handles. So you'll notice here, let me just isolate this curve so we can see it. Here we go. So on this, you'll notice that there's a line between them, and the arrows show the direction that the line is going, and they're called the normals. And then we have two points on the end of each handle, and these points allow us to rotate the curve around to get what we want. We can also, if we hit T, we can change the spline type. If we select and just hit Set Spline Type to Poly, Bezier, or NURBS, actually, that's not what I was looking for initially. Instead, what I'm looking for is the handles. We can actually set it to Auto, which is where it currently is, where basically just kind of rounds the curve out based on the extrusion, so it interpolates it. Then we also have Vector, such that we just have a sharp line. So you'll notice that now when I move this point, it then has a sharp point right in here. So if I were to actually just say extrude this from here, you'll notice that I just have a sharp corner right here. We can set this to align, which is actually that was the default one. And then there's auto, which auto is a little bit different. Well, auto and align are actually pretty similar, and for most purposes, you can just kind of use them as the same. But then there's also free, which is similar to vector, where we can move each handle independently, but it still smooths it out. So in this case, if I were to set this one to free, then this corner is still rounded rather than being sharp, but now I can separate it at the center point. So this one can go its own direction, and this one can go its own direction. So it allows you to get a little bit more control. For what we're doing, I'm just going to go ahead and delete these points, and then I'll select this one. I'll just hit E to extrude it again. And this time I'll go the direction of the normals, and we'll just scale these down a bit. For this, we're just going to go ahead and use the align or the auto, just basically default to get us what we want. So let me first hit Tab to leave. Edit mode, I'm going to hit Alt-H to reveal my objects again, reselect the curves. I'm going to hit Shift Space, and let's first add in a mirror modifier. We can use many of the modifiers that we use are available for curves as well. So we'll add that in, and then let's go ahead and just hit Tab to go into edit mode. We'll first select everything, and then we're going to rotate this around, and then I'll move it down, hit 3 to go into side view. And let's just rotate this or move this down. Let's select this handle here by just right-clicking on the center one and just move it roughly into place, maybe scale it down a bit, right to the center of that exhaust outlet. So then we'll rotate this such that it matches this angle. And let's just go ahead and position it. In fact, let's position it accurately. So let's select this, hit Tab, go into edit mode. With that loop select, I'm going to hit Shift S and cursor to selected. Then I'll hit Tab to leave edit mode, reselect my curve, hit Tab to go into edit mode, and with this point selected, I'll hit Shift S and selection to cursor, and that way it's just positioned perfectly. So now I just can manipulate this one, and I'll first just move it over here. Let's go ahead and scale it down so that we're not seeing this kind of loop back. So we'll just scale this down. We can actually go ahead and scale this one way down as well, and we'll move it down, rotate it around, maybe scale it up just a little bit. You can use the scaling to basically determine the size of an arc. And we'll go ahead and move this over to roughly line up in here. And in this case, I'm going to go and hit N to bring up my properties panel. And underneath the curve display, I'm going to turn off the normals just because we really don't need them at this point, at least for the time being. You can also, if you want to see them, just turn them down such that they're not nearly as strong. Maybe that's what we'll go ahead and do for now, just so that we can see them and get some feedback from them. But what I want to do with this curve is just to bring it around such that my exhaust pipe, which we'll create from this curve, is basically going to curve around this piece through here and then go through this inset that I have right here, and then the exhaust outlet will place right in here. So let's just rotate this around with a nice curve, something like that. I can hit E to extrude to add a new segment, rotate it through here, maybe make this pretty much straight, go right in that corner, and then I'll hit E to extrude again and then lock to the Y axis and bring it out to about right there. Then hit 3 to go to side view, and I can go ahead and bring this up along the Z-axis, maybe rotate a little. I'll take this one up, just so that it's roughly in place. And then maybe I'll take this, something like that. Okay, now this may not make a lot of sense yet, but it will in just a second. I'm gonna go ahead and hit Shift Space. And now's where we're gonna do the really cool part for the curves in this case. Let's go over to the curve properties here, or the object data properties, and we've got a few options that we can work with. And the main one that I want to work with right now, you know, rather than just giving you a full rundown on everything, is we're just going to go ahead and use the bevel option. And as I slide this up, you'll notice that we're creating a shape along that curve. But currently, it's just basically an L shape or a triangle shape that's not solid. And in order to make this a solid tube, what we need to do is go ahead and turn off the front and the back fill, and now you'll notice that we have a solid tube, or in this case, just a square, going all the way through. And so using this, we can now basically create tubing very, very easily. But in order to get it rounded, we just need to increase the resolution here to, say, let's actually just do a resolution of 1, which effectively gives us a 3-vertex circle here that we can then later work with, and looks pretty good. So what we want to do now is just go ahead and select all of our curves, and we can adjust the scale of the circle at any one point in time. So if I were to say select this point and hit Alt S, you'll notice I can define the size of my tubing at that point. So since this I want this to be consistent, I can just select everything and rotate it around here so I can kind of see this point. Let's just hit Alt S, scale this down until it fits right about in there. I can go and hit Control 7 to go to bottom view, see this a little more accurately. We want to go ahead and match this angle, so let's just bring this over along the x-axis, maybe rotate it a bit, bring it a bit more. We can go ahead and select this, rotate that, maybe we can bring this out a little, there we go, take this down a little more, scale it down, maybe take this handle out just a bit more, there we go. And that looks pretty good. So you notice that it's just kind of, it's following the shape of this whole piece. Maybe I can select this and we'll rotate it around from the side view to bring it up a bit more. Maybe I'll pull this one out just such that it's got a consistent angle right through here, but then that also pushes that up to then fit the kind of shape of the base a little better. And what we can also do is, first off, we'll save our file. We can then add in a subsurf modifier to this, basically treating it as if it were a mesh that we just extruded. So we'll add in a subsurf modifier and keep that just where it is. Maybe turn on optimal display so we can just see the topology of just the curve. And then the last thing I want to do is you'll notice that the number of lines that we have through here is perhaps a little extreme for having, you know, if we were to do this out of a mesh. And so the way I will fix that is let's just turn down the resolution here to, say, well, we can kind of rotate around so this looks good. You'll notice that as I take this up or down, we can increase the number there. And maybe actually 4 looks pretty good. And by default, the render value, if we just leave it at zero, it just uses the preview resolution. But if you wanted to take this really high to make that really smooth at render time, you could also do that. But so that looks good. And I think at this point, we'll just go ahead and leave that as is. But what we'll be doing, as soon as we get all these tubings exactly like we like, we can actually hit Alt-C and convert this to a mesh, which let's just go and do it right now just to demo it. We can convert it to a mesh from a curve, and then just hit Tab to go into edit mode, and you'll now notice that we have a really nice mesh that, you know, we definitely could have created strictly from a mesh, but it would have been a little bit more difficult. Just leave in edit mode, I'll just hit Control-Z a couple times to undo that. There we go. Now it's a curve again, as indicated from right in here. And let's go ahead and just select that curve, and we'll just hit Shift-D to duplicate it. Right-click, hit Tab to go into edit mode, select everything. Or actually, you know what? I'm just going to select these two handles, and I'm just going to hit X and delete them. So I just have these two. And let's add in our other ones. So first, let's maybe go ahead and add in, well, we'll leave these back here for the tail area. But we've got, I think we had a couple in here. Let's maybe add some in right in here. So we'll move this over. We can then rotate this. We'll maybe scale this down. Bring it up through here. Bring this around. Let me go ahead and rotate this around the Z-axis, say 45 degrees. Bring it in. Or we can maybe even rotate a little bit further and then extrude again. Then rotate this around. Maybe hit S, X, and 0 to straighten it out. Scale this down. Bring this up. We can select everything and hit Alt S. Scale these down a bit. There we go. And so we can go in and just add in a lot of detail like this very easily that otherwise would be quite difficult or time consuming to do. So, you know, maybe I'll go ahead and let's select this again. I would like to add one all the way through here, but you know what? I'm just going to go ahead and select this. In this case, I'll hit Shift D to duplicate it, bring it over, let's rotate this around. Pull it down along the Z-axis. We can go and hit Tab to go into edit mode. Let's select it. We'll scale this down. And I guess actually I made this one out of a curve as well. Then I'll go and hit Alt-S. Scale it up. Take it up along the Z-axis. Scale it down a little bit more. Rotate this around the X just to fit a little better. Okay. That looks pretty good, but I don't want this second piece in here, so what I'm going to do is hit Tab to go into edit mode, and initially you might think that we just go ahead and hit X and delete this segment, but you'll notice that it does a couple things. First, it adds in this extra loop, which we really don't want here, so let's hit Alt or Control-Z to undo that. There we go. And then we're going to hit T to bring up our toolbar, and what we want to do is toggle cyclic, or you can just hit Alt-C or Alt. See, there we go. And so now that no longer is a continuous loop. So now we just need to go ahead and select everything. We can hit Tab to leave edit mode, Shift S, cursor to selected, and then hit R, double tap Z to rotate around the normals. And in this case, we want to rotate, say, I think it's 160? Nope. 180 plus 45. There we go. So now we just have basically three quarters of a circle. Hit Tab to go into edit mode, and you can see that looks pretty good. Okay, so the double tapping the Z was to rotate around the normals. Let's also go in here, and let's add in a bevel on this, such that it's actually going through the curve. So we'll select this, hit E to extrude, right-click, scale it down just a little bit, and extrude again and scale. So we have that. And let's maybe go ahead and crease, say, this edge. So we'll Shift-E, 0.8, get that a little bit sharper. Looks good. Hit 3 to go to side view. Save our file again. And those curves all look pretty good. You can see maybe we've got a little tubing in here. Some tubing up in here. These actually look to be like support beams. So again, I'll just go ahead and let's select this one, Shift-D. Move it up right through there. Hit Tab to go on edit mode. Select everything. Move it up. Rotate this around. Position roughly right in here. go and select this, SX and 0 to make sure it's straight. I'll go and hit X to delete this curve. Sometimes it's easier just to start from scratch with some curves rather than just trying to rotate it to fit. I'm going to extrude this out along the X-axis, and then I'll pull that up right in through there. And then I'll go ahead and extrude one more time, taking it along the X-axis. And on this, in this case, if you look at the mirror modifier, we've got clipping, and so we should be able to bring that right in, just like so. Looks good. Rotate this around. The clipping's a little funky with a curve that has a mirror modifier, but with a little work, you can make it work. And this green piece will actually need to be split right up in here for this to work well, but we can work with that when the time comes. And sometimes you kind of just need to rotate this around or bring it in further to make the clipping work. And I think for the time being, we probably, actually, you know what? We could even have this go over these to make it play a little nicer. You know, we can change the design there, no problem. There we go, that looks good. I'm gonna go ahead and duplicate this, Shift D, right click, and then let's just position the cursor roughly right in there, hit period to rotate around the cursor, and hit R, just rotate this down, and then I'm gonna go ahead and deselect everything but the center one, hit X, and delete segment. So these are actually going to merge together, or they're not gonna actually merge together, but it will look like it does, just like that. And then these ones need to rotate down further. I'll go ahead and hit comma to rotate around the individual center. There we go. Move that around. And then I want to bring these pieces in along the x-axis there, so they're sitting behind the exhaust, about like that. And then I'm going to bring this on down and curve around right through there. You know, whether that's actually how it is supposed to be, I'm not sure, but I'm going to make it like that. And you know what? Let's go ahead and bring these out along the y-axis a little bit more, rotating as well, so they fit along that ridge. I'll select this, hit E to extrude, rotate it down, bring it through like this. And then I'll go ahead, bring this out along the x-axis. And then extrude in again. And rather than having that end right there, I'm just gonna go ahead and make this follow this ridge. And I'm just gonna extrude in one more time and go right through underneath the paneling. So it'll actually kind of work as a trim piece. There we go. And let's see if we've got any others that we can do right here in the main front section. We can add, this is actually a really easy way to just add kind of subtle detail. So what I'll go ahead and do is let's just select these two pieces. We'll hit Shift D, bring them down here. Let's maybe bring this curve around just to smooth it out a little. Let's maybe select these two. And you notice this is still part of the same object. We'll just hit Alt S, scale these down. Bring it over here, let's hit W and subdivide. I'll just add in a new handle between them. We can move this up, rotate it around, bring it in here, rotate this around, something like this. Let's also rotate this. Maybe scale to 0 along the y-axis roughly and along the z, just such that it's horizontal. Bring it over here. Scale this way down to get a little bit of a sharper corner on this. And then on this, we'll just extrude straight in along the x-axis. We can select the whole piece by hitting L, bring it over here. Let's go ahead and select these. We'll hit S, X, and 0.
If I deselect these pieces, the corner, are they end handles? I can just hit SX and 0 to bring those in straight. Bring that along the X-axis a little bit more to compensate for the current corner. Go, and then I'll just take that up a little further. So then that just helps add in some little detail, and then I could go ahead and select this maybe and hit Shift D, add in another one, which I'll then just pull back a little further such that it's behind it. And in this case, I'll select this, rotate it around, bring it down here, select these, W, subdivide, curve this around such that it's kind of rotating around this central piece. And I can select that by hitting Control L. I'll hit Shift D, bring it up like this. Maybe rotate just a little bit. And there we go. So again, just extra detail in there that's really easy to do. And let's see. We could even add in some little ones right through here. So maybe I'll select this, select this one here, I'll just hit Shift D, scale it way down, and I'll go and hit E to extrude, bring it down here, rotate to roughly match this angle. Same thing there. Hit Control L to select the entire piece, hit Alt S, scale it way down, something like that. Select the whole thing, move it over along the X axis just a little bit, curve this down, pull this handle down just to match this curve a little bit. Then I'll select the whole piece, Shift D, bring it over, we'll just do 3, we'll pull that one up there, rotate it around, and then this one, we'll just put a little bit more in the center, bring that up like that, just kind of average them out, and there we go. More just little detail that really helps. And let's see. We really ought to add one right through here. So I'm going to go in here. Let's select this piece. I'll hit Shift D, bring this over, bring it over along the X-axis. Move it until it just kind of intersects about like that. Take this right up to the corner. Then I'll just extrude, take it down there. And just extrude in there once and follow through right in here and scale it up to get a nice gradual curve on this. Maybe that's a little bit too much. There we go. Let's see. Seeing as these are hydraulic, we really ought to add in some tubing to those. So let's go ahead and select these two pieces. We're gonna hit Shift D, right click, R, Z, 90 degrees. Move it up over here, hit Alt S to scale it up a fair bit. We're just gonna take this in and then down, such as kind of just hiding in there. So maybe this tubing is going back behind this. And then we'll take this one, move it back along the X-axis, and we'll just hit E to extrude, rotate this down, rotate through to here, and then let's just bring it over, hit E to extrude, take it straight down. Let's go and hit Control L to select the entire loop, and we'll hit Alt S, scale that way down. Definitely a little too large. Scale these to 0 along the X-axis, straighten them up. Actually, this one could go ahead and curve out just a little bit. You know, there's definitely some flex in the tubing. And since this is all the way up, it needs some room to play for when the wheel is down. So we'll just scale this up just a little bit, bring this over like this, add in that little extra piece there. Let's go into the wheel piece, hit Tab to go into edit mode. I'm just going to select this circle, Or actually, it looks like we have a random circle just kind of hanging out down here. So let's just actually rotate this around 90 degrees around the x-axis. Pull this up. Then we'll hit E to extrude. Take it up a little bit more. Extrude again. And again, scaling it down just to create a sharp corner. And we'll scale down one last time. And that will create the tubing input. Move this along the y-axis a little bit and the x-axis. There we go. And these actually need inputs and outputs on both sides. So to do the other side, we'll just go into edit mode again, select this curve or circle, hit Shift D, and then Y to snap to the y-axis, move it over to the other side, about like that. And then we can go ahead and hit Tab to leave edit mode. And then I will select my curve, hit Shift D to go into edit mode. And then let's actually go ahead and select this one, and we'll hit P and separate by selection, just such that it's, you know, since this one would be one that you would animate more than the rest of the others, which are more static, this way it would just kind of keep them separated by function, kind of. So now I'll hit Tab to go into edit mode. I'll hit Shift D, and we're just going to move this one over a little bit. Maybe actually select all these, move them up a bit. And then this will actually be the interior one, which I guess I don't really need to worry about so much for the time being. And so let's just select this. Excuse me. And we're just going to move these over here. About like that. We can rotate it a little bit, bring it up, take this over. And if you need to ensure that this doesn't really bend, you can add in a second curve right next to it, maybe scale it way down. There we go. And so that way that will maintain its angle nicely. There we go. And this one definitely needs a little bit more play in it, since it needs to be able to rotate or basically bend, go all the way down. And so let's just add in kind of a loop on this. So I'm going to select these and this. I'll hit W, subdivide, add this in, scale this up. Maybe bring that over. We can then rotate this around the Z-axis, maybe this around the X-axis or Y-axis a little bit. There we go. I'll go ahead and bring this around a bit. Let's go ahead and hit W, subdivide on this, just to make it a little bit smoother. There we go. Okay, and then just to kind of replicate this on the backside real quick, I'll select this whole piece. I'm going to deselect these curves. I'm going to hit Shift D, move them in along the x-axis to that tubing. Go ahead and select these, and actually we'll select these ones as well. Move them along the y-axis just to fit a little better. And then we'll just pull that down, rotate this over. And for this, you know, we can actually just kind of hide that back in there somewhere. You know, that's the nice thing is that in 3D, we get to fake a lot of things. And so it's okay if that doesn't actually connect perfectly. We don't really care. So we'll save that. And notice these don't have their subsurf modifier on them yet, so I'm going to go ahead and add that in and increase that to 2. Go over here, select everything, and shade smooth. Add in loops. And of course, along the bottom as well. And along that side. We'll go ahead and go right through there as well. There we go. So now those actually show up nicely in here rather than just being hidden. That looks pretty good. I'm going to go and add in one more loop here just to make a sharper corner. And okay. Looking pretty good. Let's go and add in one more of these, but smaller. So I'll just scale this down, rotate this around, bring it in along the x-axis. That way it just kind of continues that pattern on down to give it kind of a purpose of sorts. Select this interior loop, just bring it in along the x-axis such that it's not just hanging out. Same thing with this one, maybe. Looking pretty good. Okay, I'm going to go in here. I'm just going to select these. Let's select, say, these loops and these loops. And then I'm going to deselect all of this and all of this and that. So I just have this end minus that vertex. I'm just going to hit Shift D, move this up a little bit, and we'll scale down along the x-axis, bring it in along the x-axis, and let's just hit E to extrude. Then we'll scale this along the y-axis about like that. Let's go ahead and select each of these end faces that we've now created. We'll hit X and delete faces, and then we'll just add in another edge loop right up to that corner. Let's go ahead and select the whole piece. We maybe moved it in a little too far. There we go. So again, that just, you know, adds in another level. Maybe we can add in two edge loops here, and then we'll hit E to extrude. Take it in just a little bit, and then a little bit more. And then we can go ahead and hit Control Tab, go into edge mode, deselect these in-between edges. Okay, actually, we'll just deselect everything, and then go ahead and select these edges like that and like that. So just using loop select, and then we'll hit Shift E, 0.8, and that will just crease that up. So again, just kind of helps add more detail. We can do the same thing here. We could switch into vertex mode, and actually, I'm going to undo that, and let's go in here. We're going to select, say, that loop. And then we're going to hit V to rip that apart. Actually, no, let's undo that. Instead, we're going to go into face mode, alt-right-click on this loop, and then we're going to go ahead and select this one, and that's it. So now I'm just going to hit Y and split, and that will split those apart. I can now go back to vertex mode, zoom in here, and alt-right-click until this edge loop is selected, and you can tell it's the right one because it's connected here. I'll just move that along the y-axis just a little bit, and then I can add in my two edge loops here, which then I will extrude in along the x-axis just a little bit, and then again, and maybe one more time, and I'll hit Control Tab, go into edge mode. I'll select that edge loop, and shift right click select that edge loop. I'll hit Shift E and 0.8, and if I rotate around, you can see how that now looks. Maybe I'll go in here and select, say, that edge loop and that one, and again hit Shift E, 0.8, just to crease up those corners so you can't really see it. There we go. Maybe I'll go ahead, hit Control Tab, go into vertex mode. Let's position the cursor right about there, and from the side view, position it right about there. Now hit Shift A, add in a circle, hit F6, take that circle down to, say, 8 vertices, take the size to 0.1, and I'll change it to align to view. Then I can go ahead and move this up about like that. I'll hit E to extrude, scale it in just a little, and then I'll extrude in again. On this, I can then select four vertices, hit F to fill a face, select them again, and then I'll select the outer loop. I'll hit E to extrude, take it in a little bit along the x-axis, and then even further. Then I'll select the whole thing with L, hit W, and shade smooth. Move it in along the x-axis. Let's go and hit shift space and assign the correct material. On this, I'll just use my dark gray still. And that looks good, but I want to go ahead and maybe move it over here. Maybe scale, excluding the x-axis so it doesn't mess up my position. And now with that scale, it just kind of matches this loop in here that I've added a little bit better. There we go. Just kind of, you know, helps add in some filler detail. It doesn't necessarily need to have a function, but it helps with a lot. These pieces are kind of bothering me, so the way I'm going to fix that is with more curves. So I'm going to select these two vertices, or these two handles. I'll hit Shift D, rotate this down. Then I can rotate this around the Z-axis a little bit, and then pull it out such that it matches this approximately. And I like that half intersection there. So now I'm just going to hit Shift-D, take it down along the Z-axis. Down another one. Maybe we'll move it over along the Y a little. Let's go and select both of these, and we'll hit Alt-S. Scale them down just a little bit. And then I'm going to extrude this. Scale it way down, and then rotate it such that it's going into this piece. I can do the same thing here. And maybe I could go ahead and just scale these pieces down a little so you can kind of see it a bit better. We can select these, pull them in along the x-axis a little bit. There we go. And maybe this bottom one, I'll go ahead and take it down, and I'll let it follow this curvature. So then I'll take that up like that. Then right in here, I need to take this up along the z-axis. Let's go ahead and take this handle way down to about there. Pull this in along the x-axis. It's actually select both these, hit SX and 0, and then pull them in. We'll go a little further with this one, actually. And I'm going to do the same thing. I actually kind of like this sitting behind it a bit better, so I'll do the same thing right up here. So I'll first select this one, move it up, and I'll go ahead and select these two, hit W, subdivide, add in a second one. Take it right up to this corner here, scale it down, move it in along the x-axis, maybe rotate it around the z-axis a little bit. There we go. That starts to look a little bit better. On these, I kind of want to define a little bit more. If they're structural, I'm going to give them a dark gray material. So we'll go ahead and add in a new slot on this one. We'll choose the dark gray. I'll click Assign. Let's go and hit Control-I, and we'll add in another slot, which we'll set to the light gray. We'll click Assign. And so the dark gray structural ones, assign those. Okay, so those ones are structural. And then if they're kind of like engine details, then they'll keep that. If they're, say, flexible tubing, maybe I'll go ahead and give them the... actually, let's go ahead and give them the green color then. Remember that all of these, you know, all of these materials are completely just representative. You know, once you were to actually say, if you were to go in and start texturing this or whatever, then I'm sure that your materials and such would change. Base, you know, you'd have one for every kind of material or surface rather than just, you know, a few for everything. So now, like, some of them that are more like electrical wires and such, I'll keep those. Those actually all look pretty good. Let's go ahead and just for some variety, let's select this. We'll assign that the dark gray. And we'll go ahead and assign these the dark gray. There we go. Looks good. This ought to probably also get the dark gray. And as should this. There we go. Now you can see things are really starting to come together. Looks good. Looks good. Let's maybe go ahead and add in. No, I won't worry about another one of those. Let's see. I'd like to add another set of tubing right through here. So let's select this piece. We'll select this one. Shift-D. I'm going to hit S, Y, and negative 1. Just kind of mirror it. So now I've still got my angle in here. I'll bring this out along the x-axis to right about like that. And then I'll move over here. Slide that up. Rotate around so this angle matches roughly. Take this over like this. Make it match a little bit more. And then I'll hit E to extrude. Rotate around. And then bring it up into there. There we go. More Nice detail. And that looks pretty good. We could go ahead and... no, never mind. Let's see, I'd really like to just finish off this section in this part. So let's go ahead and here. I'm going to... Let's select this, hit Shift-H, hit Tab to go into edit mode. And let's first just add in a new edge loop right up to that edge, sharpen that. And let's add in another edge loop right up to that edge, sharpen that. That all looks good. I'd like to go ahead and select this edge loop, and let's just hit Shift-E and 0.5, just to crease that a little bit. We could go ahead and do the same thing right here, so Shift-E, 0.5. We don't want to do too much, or you're going to see some artifacts through there. But let's go ahead and now. We're going to have a bunch of tubing. If we hit Alt-H, there'll be a bunch of, like, you can actually see them. I'm not sure where you can see them, but we're going to have a bunch of tubing come out of here. And so an easy way to solve this mesh problem that we have in here, which, if you can see, you know, we could add in another, or I guess actually these already line up. So we could just fill it in, but instead we're going to make this basically a hole. So let's just select these pieces, and we're going to take this up about like that. That looks pretty good. We're going to add in, or we'll actually just select this edge. We're going to hit Shift-E and 0.8, crease that. Let's take this. I'm going to take these, take them up along the Z-axis a bit more, and then we're going to extrude them along the Y, take them down. Maybe not quite that far, and we'll take this. We'll go ahead and fill in that edge. We can add in a new edge loop there, and we'll select these four, hit F to fill a face. Let's select all these now, and we'll hit E to extrude, take it back, or actually let's scale it down just a little bit, and then we'll extrude along the y-axis a little, and then again along the y-axis, and that gives us a basically a route that tubing is going to then come from to do go on back. Now, we won't add that now just because it's part of the back section more than the front, but I do want to say smooth this out a little bit, so I'll bring this up. I'll take that up. And there we go. So now the tubing will just come back through there. Now I notice that we've got a little bit of surface problem there. Okay, let's go and hit Alt-H, unhide everything. And we can see all these. Let's go ahead and take these pieces. I just want to butt it right up to this piece right here. That looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and select this. Just add a little extra. Let's hit Shift-D, scale it down just a little bit. Take it back along the y-axis, and maybe we'll do that one more time. Three to go to side view, and we can see how that's looking. So it just adds a little extra in there. Maybe we'll select all of these. We'll take it up along the z-axis a little bit. And actually, let's rotate around, say, the x. There we go. That looks pretty good. Maybe we'll delete that third one. Maybe three is too many, but two looks pretty good. But let's scale that second one down a bit more so they're definitely separate. And we'll go ahead and select both. We'll take it back out along the X just a little bit to get rid of that intersection. And there we go. Now let's go ahead and take these handles. We'll scale them out along the X-axis such that they line up right through there. There we go. And maybe we could even improve this by going in here, adding in the edge loop. Take these, take them back in along the X just a little bit. And then we'll just select this. Let's select that loop as well, or this one. There we go. We'll hit E to extrude. Take it out just a little bit. And then one more time. There we go. Just adds in a little extra kind of details such that it looks like they're actually meant to be there. And that looks pretty darn good at this point. Let's see if there's anything else we can do just kind of last minute. Let's maybe actually just go in here. Let's select these pieces. And let's just hit Shift D. Bring them back through here. Bring them in along the x-axis. Maybe rotate around a bit. Bring them up. Rotate in here. Maybe select this last one. Hit X, delete vertices. Select these three. Maybe this one, we'll just go ahead and deselect that part. Bring that out in there. There we go. Just helps add in another kind of level of detail that you can't really see. You know, it's not prominent, but it's just that extra, like, you know, surface detail in the back that otherwise might, it would appear that something's just not quite finished. Right in here, I want to select this piece and that piece. I'm just going to take it up along the z-axis such that it lines up in there. We can go ahead and select this one and this one, take it down. There we go. Maybe this one we will just move up such that it follows that curve rather than just going through it. Bring that one down a little. Okay, and I think at least for the time being, we will go ahead and call that done for the midsection in chapter 4. You know, I'm sure that as we go along, whoops, that piece is not meant to be part of that. We'll just select that, separate by selection. While we're at it, let's just control N, remove those. Yeah, so as we're going along, I'm sure that we'll find some other pieces that will kind of get added in here, particularly once we add in those. Actually, one last thing that I do want to do before calling this complete. We're going to select this piece. We're going to hit Alt-C, convert it to a mesh, because then I'm going to go in here. We're going to select this. We're going to hit E to extrude, right-click, scale it down, E to extrude again, right-click, and then take this in just a little bit. And then again, hit Control 7 to go to top view, see if we need to move it over, which we do just a little. There we go. We'll add in another loop right up to that corner or that edge. We can go ahead and select this piece, hit X and delete vertices. Since we converted it to a mesh, we need to re-add our subs or our mirror modifier. There we go. And on this, that looks good. What I will do is I'm just going to add in another loop right here. I'm going to select these, hit E to extrude, Alt S, scale it up just a little bit, and then E to extrude again, Alt S, and then hit S and double tap. I guess we can't really. We can just scale it down just a little bit, and then Alt S. Never mind, we'll just leave it just like that. Let's go and add in another loop. Or actually, rather than loop, let's hit Shift-E, 0.5, and Shift-E and 0.5. Also add in a subsurf modifier, optimal display. There we go. And then let's just go in, let's select this, and let's just rotate it ever so slightly. There we go. And then let's also finish off this piece right here. We'll just select this, move it back, hit E to extrude, rotate down, and again, and then we'll just bring it in right there. It's again, just another kind of little final touch that helps. And maybe on these, actually, we go ahead and select this loop, hit Shift S, cursor to selected, then we'll select all this, hit period, and then scale We should be able to... Actually, you know what? Let's add a little bulge to this. We just scale out away from the cursor, and then away from there, and then deselect that, and one last time. There we go. Just adds a little bit of extra flare, and no pun intended, to that. Scale it down just a little bit. Maybe slide that loop a little bit closer. We can go ahead and crease this, say, shifty 0.5, and the inside one shifty and 0.5 should be enough. And there we go. Okay, so we're going to call the engine complete. That finishes chapter 4, and we're ready to move on to chapter 5 on detailing the wing section. So hope that you're sticking with me. We've got a ways to go still, but definitely making some good progress.